All right, welcome to episode 5 of Minechat. We're in an awesome new world here. I've got Rob Newbury with me, as always.
Hello.
Hey, Rob. My name's Colin Gallagher, and we're with Elfie today. Please introduce yourself, Elfie.
G'day, guys. Elfie here. Welcome, I guess.
Yeah, thanks a lot. It's lucky we're not afraid of heights or anything.
Yeah.
Well, it's not meant to scare you. It's just meant to sort of allow you to get an overview.
All right, so whereabouts are you, Elfie, and who do you teach?
I'm in Victoria, Australia, and I teach secondary school students, so 12 to 18-year-olds, and I teach maths and science mostly.
Oh, fantastic. So it's a double whammy for me, first time in a Minecraft Edu world and first time in a maths-based world. I know later on in another episode we'll go into one of your maths worlds, so we can start off here and you can tell us where we are.
Alright, so this is a map I made to demonstrate an animal cell. So there are, we're working with MinecraftEdu, and MinecraftEdu you can host a custom texture pack on the server, so when you guys log in you get the texture pack sent to you and you see it as I want you to see it, if that makes sense. So this there's a spawn block here in the middle that allows you to really control where students spawn. So as soon as you come in, you spawn on that block, and that's it. There's no other option unless you've already been in the world. So this platform is just here to give you an idea of the scope of the cell below us. So enjoy the view.
Yeah, it's great. So do we go down into it, or what's the deal?
Well, there are four observation platforms, they're called, dotted around the cell, that you can look at it from different angles. So if you come over here and right click on this block in front of me here, you should have one option of where you can go, and it'll probably say observation 2 or something like that.
Yeah, all right.
So if you click on that, you'll disappear over to observation
2.
Whoa,
you just disappeared. You just flew down there. That was weird.
Oh wow, I'm closer.
Hey, get out of my way.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
It's like a real tourist observation deck. Get out of my way.
Yeah, so, and then, so, again, just a different angle, different view. So if you just keep clicking through, you'll go to observation 3.
Moving to a new location. There we go.
And I think there's observation 4 as well. Yeah, there is. So if you head to observation 4, and then after that you end up in the cell. Now, alongside this, I actually had booklets for the kids. So they were working on the computer. Is it me, or have you guys disappeared?
I just went to number 4.
There we go.
Where's Colin, though?
I'm at Rob. Hang on. Oh, I went to observation 4. Hang on a sec.
Okay, I can't see you.
Right click to
enter. Maybe you'll come back soon.
All right, so do we go Golgi, Smoothie, or Ruffy?
You go wherever you want. So from here, it was student-directed, so they could go anywhere they wanted within the cell. And then there's information blocks. So where did you guys head?
I'm going to go to the... Are you going to go to the Golgi? Okay, Golgi.
So there's information blocks here with the main organelles. So if you click on that blue eye, with a right-click on that blue eye, you get a bit of text that I wrote about that particular organelle. And then their booklet had questions based on the information in there that they had to sort of answer in the booklet and reflect on some things. Like one question was, why does the Golgi apparatus, the cell membrane, and something else, the vacuole maybe, why do they all have a similar colour tone? Why do you think the maker chose those colours?
Mm-hmm. Wow, it's amazing. It's like that... Rob, you're a movie buff. What's the name of the movie where they go inside the body?
Oh, Inner Space.
Inner Space, yeah.
Yeah.
This is amazing. So, like, this is what I wanted to know about using Minecraft with science or maths. It's not a case that the students have to be building stuff all the time. It can be an immersive guided tour of places, basically.
Oh, yeah. I was actually originally going to build this and then get the students to build a plant cell beside it. So it was going to be, this is an animal cell, it was going to be their job to build a plant cell and contrast and compare the two. But this took me so long to generate that I felt that the time probably wasn't worth it for the kids, if that made sense.
Yeah. Yeah, so this
how long did this take you to make?
More hours than I care to count. It was probably a 6-month project on and off.
Is it block by block?
Well, yes, it was. Wow. There was a little bit of world edit. I was just beginning to understand world edit at the time, so there's a bit of copy paste for the ribosomes, which are the how would you describe little, them?
Yeah,
the,
like almost like tea,
maroni coloured things. Yeah, the tea things. So there was a bit of copy paste there, and there was a bit of replace such and such with a percentage of this and that to try and get the rough ER over there, which is the red and black spotty thing. And the same with the nucleus and the nuclear pores. There was a bit of replace there, but most of it was just with the long build tool available in Minecraft Edu.
What does the long build tool specifically
allows you
do?
To build up to 75 blocks away. So you guys can have a play in a minute if you want. You can. I'll get you to re-log in as teachers, and you can have a fly around and have a look at the options in Minecraft Edu that allow you to sort of manipulate the student experience, if you will. So
it's great.
I can't get over this. This is huge. This is a tremendous amount of work.
This is probably, I think I said at the time, this is probably the coolest thing I've ever made. The coolest thing educationally I've ever done. And the coolest thing I've ever made in Minecraft. So,
yeah, it's really cool, man. It's huge.
It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. And so this is the power of Minecraft EDU, basically. These portal blocks or whatever.
The teleport blocks, the teleport and those blocks. Blue eyes, information blocks.
Right.
So you can store a heap of text in them. Now, these were in the game before the books came along, before the editable books. So I'm starting to use these in concert with the in-game books as well. So they're really, for a stationary information thing, they're great.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Now, can you, you know, when you click on the information block and you've got the text there, can you insert an image in there as well, or is it just text?
Just text.
Just text.
They're working on a link block at the moment. At least I think they're working on a link block so that you can put YouTube video links and it'll open up in the browser, and you could put a sound link and it would open up in the sound player on the computer. So that's what they're working on that.
Which part of the cell are you guys in now, so I can?
I'm inside the nucleus.
Inside nucleus. Okay.
And I'm with Rob.
All right.
Because I can see Rob.
I don't see you.
It's the teleporting around. I don't know if this is a Minecraft thing or a Minecraft EDU thing. I think it's actually a Minecraft thing. The teleporting around does cause some invisibility issues.
Oh. Okay.
So you're here with us right now.
I am. Well, I don't know about Colin,
spirit.
But I'm here with Rob.
I'm here too.
Colin, who do you see?
I can see Rob.
I don't see either of you guys.
Interesting.
<That's> strange. I feel like I'm having a very strange experience. These people are talking to me. I'm just kind of walking around inside of a cell. It is inner space.
Yeah. It's amazing. So there was a little. So once you're inside the cell, you can't go back outside to the outside observation.
No. So it's a one-way trip. Once you get in, you're stuck in.
Yeah.
So it was basically designed just to get the students moving around and giving them... I mean, this is how I view a cell in my head.
Right.
So normally I do this in a two-dimensional format on the board with very similar colors. Right. The mitochondria are always orange and the lysosomes always yellow and, you know, all that sort of stuff. So alongside that, this last year I did this as well and got the kids to tour through it. So...
That's great. So what would you like us to do? Okay, so we've logged back in as teachers. We've had to discreetly edit out the password, which is it's so cryptic and confusing. I had to try it a couple of times. So yeah, don't even try to get into this. All right, see
so if
you both now.
Press P now, you get access to the real power of Minecraft Edu.
All right, so you're going to have to, this is important stuff here. This is first time stuff for us. So you're going to have to talk us through this.
So I'm pretty sure when you open P, you've got some buttons on there, teleport yourself to spawn and creative mode, self and spectate mode.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yep.
So that allows you to move yourself around and change your movement speed and actually make yourself invisible or turn on your own creative mode.
Okay.
So that's just for personal thing. If you go over to the next tab, this is a bit newer and I think it's going to change in the actual update. So this is a pre-release. but you've got the game mode, the difficulty, the ability to freeze students, so to stop them moving, mm-hmm. the ability to mute students to stop them talking. You can enable play versus player, nether and end, allow students, if they get stuck in a cave, to just say, I'm stuck in a cave, and shoot straight back up to the top surface, and allow students to say, I want to go back to the spawn block, are all available there as options.
So they just there's a preset command for them to do that?
Yes, so if you escape from there and press M, you get the M for Mary.
Yep.
You get it's the student menu. Okay. But you can put assignments here and assignments, and then if those other two are, so if I set those there now, you should be able to see if you go back into the M, there's two buttons there now where the students can access and go back to spawn or back to surface.
Fantastic.
So
that's really back useful.
So back into the P menu.
Mm-hmm.
Into the next one over, the world tab.
Mm-hmm.
This is where you can change all the world settings, so allowing day, night, weather, the ability for students to build fire and TNT to work, and animals, villages, monsters, and the ability to generate structures like your villages and stuff like that you can turn on and off on the fly.
Mm-hmm. Well,
it's just a lot neater and tighter than we use MC MyAdmin on our servers, so...
Okay.
It's just this little menu right here, in game basically, is great.
Yeah, it makes a big difference.
Yeah.
The real advantage for me is at school, and the server you're on right now can't authenticate to Minecraft. So everyone would just be player 127 or player 164, and there'd be no continuity of the world.
Right.
So you wouldn't be able to keep your stuff on a log out and log back in because your player number would change.
Okay.
So this allows you to save that to a nickname. So if you guys came back in, as long as you used the same nickname, mm-hmm. you would be able to keep all your stuff and keep your location and things like that.
Oh, cool. So the next button over, give, you basically...
give it to anyone. I'm not sure the give to all works currently. I think we found that doesn't work at the moment. But yeah, you can give particular items to players.
Okay.
The next one over is where you set the assignment.
Mm-hmm.
So... I think when I originally did this map, the assignment was to explore the cell sort of thing.
Right. Yep.
The next one over is to teleport players around. So instead of having to use that slash TP command, you can just click a name and say, I want to go to them or I want them to come to me.
Okay.
Mm.
And then the next one over is the teleport stations. So as a teacher, you can actually access any of the teleport stations at any time.
Yeah.
Right. So you'll notice if you right click on that teleport block now, you'll actually get access to all the stations, not just the ones you could see as a student. So
yeah,
you can control which teleport station students can and cannot go to from a particular spot.
Mm.
And then the last tab is the powerful, awesome build tools, which we might head out of the cell and have a play with.
Okay.
So if you turn on build mode.
Turn on build mode, yep.
You'll now just be able to walk through walls. So come and walk through walls outside of the cell. Did you see which way I went?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can have a bit of a play with the...
Easy.
So it's basically no clip.
Yeah. Wow, is that ever cool?
And then, so turn... Oh, yeah, so you... Colin just disappeared into the floor. So I personally work without build mode because it's... I put myself in creative mode, so you might want to turn build mode off. You're welcome to turn it on. But you might want to turn it off. Make sure you're in creative, grab a block, and turn long build on, and see how far away you can build.
Okay. So do you set a...
No, long build will just allow you to build up to 75 blocks away. So if you just fly up a little bit, you'll be able to place a block.
Whoa, look at that.
Really far away, so... So that's what I did to build the cell membrane of the cell. I sort of just sat there and just held down right click until the cell membrane made it to me sort of thing.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, that's cool.
So there's that option. The fill clear tool is also amazing. You turn that on and then you click two points in a three-dimensional space, it will fill that space with blocks. So if you wanted to create a wall, you could just sort of fill, like I am here with the grey wool, and you can take that even further. So that's really good for creating walls and things. And then the other really cool thing in there is the place amount. So if you place, I think you can place up to, I think it's 45.
Okay.
And then you just right click, you place 45 blocks at once on in the direction in which you're how can I explain this? Do it and you'll understand.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So then if you add one to the side, it'll come out the side for 45 blocks.
Okay. Man, it looks it's like we're in a Salvador Dali world here. That's powerful, that stuff. That's really powerful.
World edit's in there as well. So you've got that as well.
So world edit is part of Minecraft EDU?
I wanted to undo all the mess. You've got the undo buttons there. So if I wanted to get rid of all my grey wool, I can just undo the last place and it'll get rid of that. And then I can undo the last fills and it will get rid of all my grey wool.
What are the commands for that? Sorry?
In the build menu, so P and then the last menu, you've got undo, fill, last place, and undo, dig.
Oh, right, yeah.
Fill is the fill tool, place is when you place a block, and dig is if you dug something you didn't want to dig. So you can just undo, I think it's up to 50 commands of each of them. So it just undoes it all.
Wow.
That's great.
So no need for those server commands. Mm. And world edit is awesome, but this sort of alongside world edit just gives you so much power for creating stuff.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, I can totally understand, you know, the cell and, you know, how you put all that together.
Mm.
Yeah.
So you're saying that world edit has been incorporated into Minecraft EDU?
Yeah, so if you do /wand, you'll get the wand and you'll be able to use world edit. So.
Yeah. Yeah, got it. Very cool. So listen, maybe we'll wrap up this episode, or unless there's anything else you want us to see in this one.
I don't think so. I was just trying to think of.
Oh, I have a question for you.
All the teacher blocks. Oh, they all look different. We might cover. Now go into your inventory. We'll talk about it here.
Okay.
I've changed the texture pack. So if you go into the inventory and hit the, what is it, right arrow up the top to get to page 2, and you've got Minecraft Edu blocks there.
There we go.
So if you grab them and have a bit of a look at them, the information block and the information sign look the same, but they're not.
Okay.
So the spawn block is literally the spawn block. It changes the spawn location in the world. This one in my hand now and on the ground in front of you stops students building on top of it. So if the world has student building on, someone's still got place amount on.
That's me.
I'm sorry.
No, that's me, I think.
So if you just undo last place, it'll pull that back down for you. And then if you click the little arrow beside place amount, it'll reset it to 1 for you as well.
There we go.
So that stops students building on top of it. Mm. And now it's also stackable. So if you wanted students not to be able to build at that level, but to be able to build at that level, students wouldn't be able to build in between the two blocks, but would be able to build above this block here and below that block there. And that's all based on the world settings as well, whether students can build or not. So if student building is off in the world, they will still be able to build on this green one.
Okay.
If student building is on in the world, they will not be able to build on top of the red one, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So it allows you to not only control whether students can build, but if they can build, where they can build, and if they can't build, spots where they can anyway. So.
Okay. So let's move on to the information block and how
that
works.
Information block is, if you place it down, that's your text block. So that's the one where all the cell information was.
Oh, it's saying, can I place more than one of these blocks at a time? I did.
Oh, your place amount is still up then.
I didn't press set when I changed it to 1. That's my problem. Noob here. Got it.
So you could just type in there, and they actually double as a small teleport block as well.
Okay.
So if you step over the top of it, Rob.
Mm-hmm. Whoops. Jeez.
Don't right click it, just walk on it. I don't know. Teleporting must be off. It's set. Okay, so if I set it to 4, there you go.
Yeah.
So now any time someone goes over this block, they actually get teleported and the text comes up to them. So you can set it so that a student can come here, step on it, they'll get the information delivered to them, and then they can't go back, so they could, you can teleport them through walls and things like that.
That's
so great. That's in the little cog icon in there as well.
And the information sign is just a place
just
where you
push, it's like a blue wool. In the actual normal texture pack, it's like a wool. Someone's still got fill tool on.
That's a lot of information there, Gally.
So you might want to turn your fill tool off.
Man, I feel like the teachers when I introduce them to Minecraft.
So in the normal texture pack, that just looks like a blue wool block with an eye on it. So I accidentally changed the texture pack for that block, and I shouldn't have. It was the wrong block to change.
Okay.
So the next one in line is the border block.
Border block, yeah. Oh, I've seen that before in a couple of videos.
Yeah, stop students crossing it, so students can't dig over it, dig under it, or fly over it, or under it, or they just cannot move past it. So you can actually control where students can and can't go with that.
That's good, yeah.
And then the next one is the spawn block, which does exactly what it says. So if you want to place it down, it tells you, it'll come up with a little thing saying spawn location set to blah.
Right.
So if any new people come into the world, they'll spawn on top of that block.
Got it, yeah. All right, and the foundation block?
Foundation block is a measurement block. This one's very tricky, so you'll need to put yourself back into build mode.
Okay.
And then if you press left control, you get locked to the center of a block and you can move around, and it tells you how far away the other foundation block is. It's very hard to explain this without being able to actually show you. So if you place one down and then organize your wireframe, so you in the one with the red wireframe. So if you go up, no, you're not, because you wouldn't be able to do that. So press left control, you're in build mode.
Yeah.
And now press left control.
I can see boxes, but I'm not sure what I'm doing.
So now move around for me, just try and move. Right, so now you're in the build mode that allows you to measure distance between blocks.
Okay.
So if you line your red box up with one of your already placed foundation blocks and then move yourself up, you'll see it'll measure how far up you've gone and tell you how far away that particular foundation block is away from you. So it's just a way you can measure accurately in Minecraft Edu if you want.
Oh, got it. Yeah. Yeah.
So if you wanted to make it 20 and then you would use the fill tool to place that sort of wall, if that makes sense.
Yeah,
so
that's a tricky one.
Yeah. And then the last block, if you jump out of build mode, is the teleport block.
Teleport. That's what we were using for the...
Yeah, and then you can choose which location students can and can't see and how far to teleport them when they come here and which way and things like that. So...
Oh, it's a whole new level for me.
It's great for working with classroom full of kids.
I'm sold too. I want to do this.
To be honest, I was actually contemplating before, like, because I'd played Minecraft for a while, and I was contemplating how to get a bucket server up and running and all the plugins and everything.
Right.
Yeah.
And then I saw this on the forums and went, I'm buying it, and now I wouldn't go any other way.
Yeah.
It's an easy install.
Now here's a question: can we can you install Minecraft Edu on a Redstone host server? Let's say, is it possible to do that? Is it, or does it have
there
to be hosted locally?
There are specific services that you can. I'm not sure if I host locally, so I'm not sure if Redstone host is one of them. I think it might be, because it's a paid product, not. Like the Minecraft server software is not a paid product, but I think because Minecraft Edu server software is a paid product, you need to be a bit more careful of where it goes.
Yeah. Right.
Well, if that makes sense.
Yeah, something to look into.
the other really powerful thing that you guys probably can't see right now, but I highly recommend you have a play with it, is the server management. So what you've got in game, you've actually got out of game in a GUI on the server console as well.
Okay.
And starting and stopping worlds as a button press, and saving worlds as a button press, and all that sort of stuff. So it just makes managing a server a ton easier as well.
Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. So we'll wrap it up here, because this has been just a mind-blowing adventure. But we're going to come back to one of your worlds. Two more of your worlds, right? We've got lined
yes.
up.
If so you've got time to keep going.
Oh, absolutely. So I think I might just kind of do a little to be continued part here, and we'll separate the episodes up. So we'll finish up of episode 5 right here, right now, and then we'll come back for the next episode. So see you in another world.
Okay.